Cromar. I'm coming to you from Colorado. I am a social media person that likes to help people build their business from social media. I've done this for a long time. And of course, this is our Pass the Cast from social media summits and from our niche summits that we're part of. We want to make sure that you know how to be part of that. You just simply find niche summits in the groups and we will, you know, it's free to be part of it. Hello, hello. Thanks a lot for coming and thanks for the hearts. I really appreciate it. It's lots of fun. Anyway, what my desire to do is to teach you today a little bit more about social media, since that's what we're talking about today. When you learn how, hello everybody, thanks for coming and thanks for the replay hearts as well. I really appreciate it. Lots of fun. Got a lot of ladies here there. I haven't seen too many of the gentlemen this afternoon. This is afternoon here where we're at. Okay, nichesummits.com. Absolutely, that's where you go for the group. Are you? And my subject line was, are you open for business? Now, I'm going to talk more about this afternoon, 6:30 p.m. Eastern time. But I wanted to get a really good start on it so that you would understand what we're talking about. So I've got here a snap of my own Periscope profile, and if you notice, I have it completely filled out. Now with Periscope, you don't have a lot of places to put information because it's all more than anything else live broadcasts for the most part. So as you can see, I have both my handle and my name and also a trigger about something that I am part of. I created a program called Parasociability. And it's a training program right now for free that I'm teaching people how to use Periscope and how to really leverage it. And also, I have right on there on my profile, you can go to my profile by simply sliding over and tapping my profile. You can pull it up without leaving the broadcast. I don't know if you knew that or not. And you can see exactly what I'm showing you here because I took this morning. And also, we now have the ability to have a clickable link. So that link is supposed to be clickable. Now I can't click it, but you're supposed to be able to. I'd love it if somebody would check because I've never found out if it actually is totally clickable. But anyway, this is where you tell people what you do. So much of the time, people don't really make it clear what they really truly do in their business. Yes, it's a great addition, isn't it, Dina? I'm really excited about it. So make sure it's clear what you do on the, you know, in your business. What is your business focus so that you can actually help that person get to know you better. So for instance, I use this particular graphic quite a bit, and this is actually the title graphic. It'll go on my blog later because I believe in repurposing your content. I did talk to somebody recently and he was saying, no, I don't actually repurpose my content. He actually has Catch Me, and I went to look and there is none of his videos in there. So he's either hiding them somewhere where he's going to use them later, or he truly does let them go away and doesn't keep them. I don't know, but I think that's kind of a waste. If you're going to spend the time to build real content to help people, then it makes more sense to have a place where it's going to go. Catch Me's one place it can go, and your blog is a second place where it can go. So make sure that your content's going to be what it needs to be so that it actually helps people and it answers a question and it tells them who you are. So when I, let me make sure I get to the right place here. I wanted to just jump over to my own profile for a moment and show you something that I think a lot of people kind of miss out on. You actually have so many places. This is in Facebook, of course, where of course we've got a lot more opportunity to share who we are. Yes, auto-save your videos and then share them directly to video, share them directly to Twitter. Absolutely, you can put them up on YouTube. You can put them all over. So why not make them good content? They don't have to be junky pieces of content. I don't believe in doing that. If you're going to spend the time, make it good stuff. So when I'm in my, this is just the personal profile at this time, and if you look, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different places where you can have content or information about your business. And I am so surprised a lot of the time when I go to see somebody and I find out that they really haven't taken the time to actually build this up. And you have so many opportunities. It doesn't have to be full of links, but you have lots of opportunities to make sure that people know how to contact you. They know how to connect with you, because people are truly interested in knowing you. And if you don't let them know you, how can you expect them to buy from you? That's going to be the biggest thing. And a lot of the time people hide all of their information. They have Ask Me on there instead of the actual information. As you can see, when I slide over here, I have my real cell phone on there. I have my real email on there. I don't care if they actually contact me. I want them to contact me. Even if they're going to spam me, that's okay. That might be a way to open the door too. So back to the question, are you open for business? Take the time to look over all of your profiles. Make sure that they are as complete as possible. Make sure they're clear so that they tell what you do and how you do it and how they can get a hold of you. Make sure that you make it easy, because most people are not going to just go digging everywhere. And a lot of people are trying to teach you to hide all this. I don't believe in that. I think you got to be open. You got to make sure that they are, you're having trouble with the sound? Okay. I didn't put on my microphone. I'm sorry. And I've been moving around, so I think that is part of the problem, is that I'm moving my body around. Is this better when I kind of stay in one spot? Make sure that you really take a really good look at all of the profiles, your Twitter, your Periscope, your Facebook. I use all three of those pretty heavily for my business. And so it's really, really important to make sure you're giving them every possible chance to connect with you, so that they can find out what you're doing. That doesn't mean that you have to spam your page. That's not value. But you can make sure that they know how to get in touch with you. And a link to get on a capture page is not unreasonable. Most of us are doing that. Okay, great. Thanks, Dina. I was kind of wrapping up, figuring that is where we're at. So to get on our little group and learn more from us, in Niche Summits, that's www.nichesummits.com. And to get in touch with me, you simply have to just go ahead and get on simplefreedomlc.com, which is also what I had. And I put that everywhere, so that's the main way that you can get on my list. It is a free training program that allows you to learn more about how to use social media and learn how to brand yourself in a very strong but simple way. Thanks very much for coming. I think we've got someone coming up in a few minutes. It's B, right? Yeah, B Smith is next, and that will make it possible. She may need maybe a few more minutes, so she says she's going now. So let's. I'll follow B Smith so that she can go ahead and share her social media tips for today. And I am very happy that I had the opportunity to share this. And then definitely tune in if you're following me this afternoon, 6:30 p.m. Eastern Time. I will go into more detail with this same subject today. So I hope you guys have an awesome day, and let's go follow Bee.